Hey there everyone, this is Michael Dougal, and I'm gonna share my experience using Cytomel during this video. It's also known as T3, so individuals would use T3 for the purpose of increasing their thyroid function. And so I'm somebody that has been diagnosed with hypothyroidism, and it's been over a decade now of trying different prescriptions, finding what works for me. And I'm happy to say that I finally found a regimen that works to some extent, though I'm still doing blood work every 6 months to see what I can do to further optimize things. So thyroid is super tricky. Now, one of the reasons why T3 is very popular isn't just necessarily for increasing thyroid function, but also for helping with fat loss. And it's more so known in the bodybuilding community. You see, when individuals would use T3, they would use it for the purpose of losing fat. Now, I don't recommend individuals do that, but that's one of the reasons why people may want to reach for the supplement. And I'm going to give you several reasons why you shouldn't do that, some of my regrets, and some of the biggest surprises in using T3 over the years. So how did I know that I needed thyroid meds in the first place? Well, what actually happened was I lost a lot of body fat. My body does not like me being under 20% body fat. However, I'm maintaining a healthy like 10 to 15% body fat these days. And what had happened was after I dieted down and lost a considerable amount of weight and stayed lean, I couldn't get my energy back up. And even after getting on TRT, which helped me with my testosterone levels, I still had blood tests done on my thyroid, and I had found that I had low T3, low T4, and I had a high TSH, which is an indication that I had low thyroid. After trying different diets, trying whatever natural practices I could do to avoid meds, I realized that it was time for me to actually try a regimen. Who knew if I was going to stick with it, but that's what I decided to do. And so how I actually started was by using Synthroid. Synthroid, also known as T4, when I still take it every single day, but there's been a lot of time that I spent off of T4, and I've really found T3 to be far more effective. Because I was using T4, I was pretty happy with the results. It was like a marginal improvement with my energy levels and my quality of sleep. And then what happened was after using Synthroid, I felt slightly better, but when I had my blood work done, it had shown that my T3 levels were still low. My T4 was up a little bit and now within a normal range. But this is the really tricky part, is that you see a lot of people discuss, don't pay too much attention to the numbers in the lab. If you feel okay, you may not want to mess with things. And while I don't agree with that when it comes to like vitamin B or checking your testosterone levels or vitamin D, I really do believe that with your thyroid. Sometimes you just got to do what feels right. And so if a practice is working for you, then you may want to consider sticking with that. So I let some more time pass. I noticed I really wasn't feeling as much better as I thought. I think that perhaps the T4 was giving me some sort of placebo effect and making me believe it was working when it really wasn't. So what happened was I approached my doctor and said, I want to use some T3. Let's see how it works. But that's what we decided to do. We decided to stop using T4 and start using T3. And we got on 25 micrograms of Cytomel per day. And I felt much better. Not only was my blood work better 6 months later, but I was feeling energetic. I could lose fat. I could build muscle. I could feel like a normal, healthy young individual. And that really made me believe, wow, T3 is far more powerful than T4. And then I started seeing a lot of anecdotes and a lot of articles that were released about this, simply saying that T4 was overrated and perhaps it doesn't do anything. Now, I don't really believe that to be true. What happened afterwards was that my blood work was showing better results. I still had like a normal thyroid range, although my T4 was lower. So not that I necessarily needed to, but I added T4 in the mix. So right now, my current regimen is 50 micrograms of Cytomel taken each day and 25 micrograms of Synthroid. So we have a good blend of T3, a good blend of T4. Now, in my case, I must admit, I don't know if I necessarily needed the T3. I'm also somebody that really loves working out. I want to make sure that I have proper energy levels. Though, if you were to take me back in time, something that I didn't realize was just how subtle T3 is. I definitely don't think it's as super effective when it comes to fat loss or with helping you with your energy levels. I'm somebody that, sure, I had low T3, but it wasn't as bad as a lot of people would imagine it to be as far as slower thinking and feeling like I'm unproductive. So if you believe that by using T3, you don't have to do cardio, boy, are you mistaken. Your cardio is going to be far more effective. I was still able to lose weight, lose body fat without using thyroid, and I had low thyroid function back then. So as long as you have a basic understanding of nutrition, you should be okay. It is worth noting though, and there is some research behind this, that if you were to lose body weight and you had low thyroid, you may be losing more muscle mass than fat mass. Of course, there's a lot of different elements to this, including how much you exercise versus how much of your caloric deficit may come from nutrition. How I feel now though, I feel great. No complaints. I can sleep well. My energy is good. All my measures on like my biohacking devices, like my Oura Ring, my Apple Watch, all show that I have a decent resting heart rate. So no complaints whatsoever. And a lot of this, of course, is attributed to good nutrition, good lifestyle practices. But although in the event that I perhaps had low thyroid throughout the past 10 or so years, then I don't believe that I would be feeling as good as I am right now. If you are considering using T3, then the first thing you want to look at is the core root of the problem. Why do you have low thyroid in the first place if you do? And one of the most common reasons individuals would have low thyroid could be similar to mine in crash dieting. If you're somebody that crash diets, perhaps you intermittent fast more than you should be, perhaps you spend too much time in a caloric deficit, or you're training for a marathon or something very intense, then I would would make sure that you address that first, fix up your nutrition, make sure that you're resting right, and likely your thyroid levels will come back. Because one of the very tricky things is that I monitor my thyroid levels and get blood tests done pretty regularly, and I find that if I am to adjust something in my diet or my lifestyle, that would actually have more of an effect than just changing up my thyroid medication protocol. And for that reason, even if I stick with the consistent medication, if I change too much in my lifestyle, my thyroid readings would not be the same. And the same thing could be said about testosterone to some extent, that if you were to check your testosterone levels recurringly, then you want to make sure that you're controlling all the other variables if possible. But I want to share with you the biggest surprise in using T3, and that's that it really didn't have any sort of short-term impact on me. So I expected that by consuming T3, I would feel like a slight energy boost or feel like I was cognitively sharper. But not only has that not been true, also when I miss a dose, I really don't feel any different. And so there has been instances when I stopped taking Cytomel for a week. Like once I traveled, I forgot to bring my Cytomel, for instance. I thought the world was gonna fall apart and I would have horrible energy levels throughout my whole trip. No, I actually felt fine. So now, for example, if I don't have my Cytomel, like there was a period in which Canada was having a very difficult time acquiring Cytomel. And so what happened was I had to take a month or two off of it. I'd use some T4, I used some desiccated thyroid during the time that I couldn't use my T3, and I actually felt okay. So really now, if you were to take away my T3 for the rest of my life, I think I would be okay with it. It was just that before, I really thought it was important, it was necessary. I felt like if I wanted to build muscle, there was no point unless I could get my hands on some T3. And now I'm happy to say that perhaps it's just a marginal benefit about better energy levels. I'm making sure that I can stay productive, though it doesn't make too much of a difference in the grand scheme of things. The other thing that surprised me was that interactions pretty much didn't happen, or didn't happen with me at least. So you hear a lot of warnings about using specific products that can mess with your thyroid. For example, ashwagandha, which is a product that I really enjoy taking for stress management. I've talked more about it in this video over here. And there's warnings around ashwagandha increasing your thyroid level. And there's other supplements out there which can do the same thing. But I had found that I was able to use them along with my Cytomel and feel just fine. As well, I've actually used Cytomel along with a light antidepressant called Wellbutrin in the past, and that worked totally fine. And so you can see why Cytomel is so popular, is that it's well tolerated, it's that individuals feel, okay, there's nothing wrong with trying a bit of Cytomel. And to some extent, that may actually be true. Now, where individuals want to be careful is using too much Cytomel, because that can be very addicting, especially if you're somebody that wants to use it for fat loss. I may warn you, I don't necessarily believe that it may shut down your natural thyroid production, but I can see why individuals may think that it could be such that if you were to use a lot of Cytomel for an extended period of time and then come off of it, perhaps you may gain weight because your thyroid levels will drop afterwards. And I really hope there's just more research done on Cytomel in the future, because I remember when I first approached my doctor about it, he was a bit skeptical about using Cytomel. He didn't really think it worked, but then he actually pointed out a study to me saying that there were a small population of people, perhaps 10 to 20%, that do respond better using T3 over T4. Some side effects you may want to be mindful of are elevated heart rate. Of course, when you're increasing your thyroid function, that may happen. And of course, when you increase your thyroid function more than necessary, weight loss could be possible, as well as either appetite increase or appetite decrease. So depending on you as an individual, I'm somebody that I actually notice that I'm slightly hungrier when I use thyroid. And that's because of the fact that perhaps my body's just burning more calories and I want more food. And something worth pointing out is that for me, I've personally found it a little bit more challenging to build muscle while using T3. Don't be too alarmed by this. It's just a hypothesis, but I found that even when I'm in a caloric surplus, it's not as if there's a better ratio of like muscle mass to fat mass. Though all the research pretty much says that provided you have decent thyroid levels, it should be better for you when it comes to building muscle and losing fat. So my point being that if you believe that by increasing your T3 levels just slightly is going to help you to build muscle, you'll probably be very disappointed if you go that route. I really hope you enjoyed the video. Make sure you share your feedback and your thoughts around using thyroid in the comment section below. Do subscribe and click like if you enjoyed the video. And if you'd like to have a conversation with me one-on-one, you can consider messaging me on Patreon. And be sure to visit our Discord server. We have a 24/7 chat room talking about discussions like these. I thank you for your support and look forward to seeing you next time.